everybody. Thanks for being here on such an early, early time on Saturday morning. We definitely appreciate your time, and I know you're here to learn something. Is that right?
Yes.
Perfect. How many people here are currently living in multifamily, a condo building, or otherwise in the Pearl District or downtown? Fantastic. How many people have a plan to evacuate the building if there's a problem? Okay, so not that many. How many believe that there is importance to have a plan in earthquake, emergency, human, or natural disasters? Perfect. Well, today we are going to spend some time, 3 hours actually, on learning from other people who do have plans that can help us in our community. Can everyone hear me? Who can? Good? Perfect. Well, I want to introduce someone who's very important to this whole process. Ladies and gentlemen, Jan Valentine. Jan leads the Pearl Neighborhood Association and the Livability Committee. And those are the folks who put this on for us today. So can we give a round of applause? I'm just going to keep it brief and simple, and we're going to get right to it. We have the Portland Fire Department here today to speak with us first. September is National Emergency Preparedness Month, and so we're taking this opportunity after the Pearl District and downtown neighborhoods finally growing. We all feel that now is the time, better than never, to have a plan to begin this process. The mission for this group is to increase our community's awareness that risk reduction can be achieved through education and emergency preparedness planning. We're also here today to take you through the resources on the tables behind you and the tools that are here to help create and implement that plan. We have resources for general planning as well as information on specific issues such as business emergency planning, plan evacuation systems for high-rise buildings, family disaster plans, pets in disaster, and preparedness and emergency plans for special needs individuals. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Bill Dolan. Bill Dolan is on the Livability Committee. He is also getting this event started for us, so thanks.
So if you could turn around for one moment, I want to recognize some of the speakers and sponsors of this event. We're going to start over here on your, well, if you turn around, it's going to be on this side of the room. We have Larry Thompson with American Family Insurance. In the back corner, I'm going to be set up, and I'm here to talk about and to help you get started with a condominium preparedness plan. There's not a whole lot of information on that, but I put together some basic information. We have Red Cross here with materials, and they'll also be presenting today. Ace Hardware is here. They have a list of items to supplement an emergency kit. Great things, and there's actually a full 72-hour emergency kit there at the table. We also have Janice and Betsy Shan, authors of How to Survive
a
Natural Disaster or a Man-Made Disaster. We have the Fire Department, which is actually the Fire Department. We'll be hearing from Captain Greg Innes here in a moment. We have Joe Guerra with Entropia. If you would mind raising your hand, Joe? And Joe is an evacuation specialist. We also have Raheem Abbasi with Abbasi Design Works, structural engineer. And we have Gary Timono, owner of Fast Signs, business partner of the Pearl District since 2001. Oh, excuse me. I also, it's Clark.
Yeah.
Clark with REI. I didn't see you underneath the van. Sorry. REI and Ace Hardware donated some really wonderful door prizes. So Brian's going to tell you some more about that. And Gary Timono, Fast Science, is our net neighborhood emergency team captain.
Perfect. Thanks, Bill. Greg is from the Portland Fire Department. He's going to give us a little talk today about how to work with them.
Good morning. How are you doing today? Hey, one of the things that we've learned is that you can never plan enough for emergencies. One of the things that we found over centuries in the fire service is that you can't predict when the disaster is going to happen. So it's really a good thing what you're doing here today is planning for something that could occur and hopefully never does. But if you have some kind of a plan and you practice that plan, you're going to be in a much better situation when you're done. I don't have anything prepared. Everything is going to be very short for me today. We're going to be at the back table, happy to answer any questions that you have about the fire service and what we do. Again, our thing is mostly response to something and planning for events so that we're ready to do what we need to do in the event of a fire, earthquake, major medical disaster, something like that. One of the things I do want to mention though as a group though is if you do have an event in the Pearl District, okay, a lot of people are going to need medical attention if it's a major catastrophe, some sort of earthquake or something like that. What you might find is that everybody's going to transition over to Good Sam Hospital and try to get into the emergency room, be seen by a doctor. At some point, that hospital is going to get overwhelmed if it's a major issue going on in the city of Portland. If it's a major earthquake here, all the hospitals could be overwhelmed. So the Fire Bureau has developed a plan of medical control points. And what that is an example of if there was a radiation issue that was going on. We have medical control points that we would set up. They're big, large tents that the Fire Bureau would operate for the first 12 hours and transition to Multnomah County healthcare and state healthcare system. And you would be turned away from the hospital to go to these medical care control points. For the Pearl District, that's Wallace Park, and it's at 25th and Pettigrove. So don't be surprised if that kind of situation occurs if we have something major in the Pearl District, okay? It takes about an hour to get the medical control point set up, but it's something that we would do right away in anticipation of thousands of patients who are worried about whatever. Maybe it's just cuts and bruises. It could be as serious as a trauma system injury for some people. Depends on the situation. For the fire department, what we do in a major event, as an example, let's use an earthquake. What we're going to do is we're going to, if the fire station itself is secure, we're going to come out of the fire station, get out whatever supplies that we need at the fire station, and then we're going to go out and survey our districts. So, for you to respond, to run to the fire station to look for us to do something for you may not be the best course of action for you, okay? If we have a major disaster in this area, every building in the area is gonna have something going on. There may be several people that are hurt in every building, and we're gonna be spread real thin. We're gonna be calling back off-duty firemen and all that kind of stuff to do what we can, but we're a limited department also. So, as much as you can possibly take care of yourself and your neighbors working together as teams is the best plan that you can have, okay? Now, we're going to be responding to major things, big things, fires that can get out of control, major medical situations where lots of people are hurt. That's the kind of things that we're going to do. If you have a gas leak somewhere and you have a team of people in your building that can shut off the gas to the building, you just solved your own problem, okay? So those kind of things you're gonna have to do at your level as much as you possibly can. Little things that aren't too difficult, but that can be trained to you in your specific building, and you can also assist other buildings in what they have. So there's lots of little issues. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. We'll be at the back table. They have an agenda here, so we don't want to infringe upon their time, but we're happy to answer questions. We'll be here till 10:30, okay? Have a good day. And I congratulate the people that set this up, because this is a really good thing. It needs to happen. And I would encourage you to take this information you get today and disseminate it out to your building residents, okay? All right, we'll see you.
I'm Steve Bullock. I'm with Multnomah County Department of Emergency Management. Have some answers for you. My area is business and community outreach. So I reach out to all communities, faith-based, NGOs, CEOs, try to get them to come together and create a plan of sustainability to take care of your own self. Because there's a limited number of firemen, which I have a statistic here, there's a limited number of police officers during a disaster, they're gonna be doing something else. So if we can teach our community sustainability, it'll take the surge off the hospitals, it'll help us out. It'll help with the mass chaos that may happen. You know, it's not if, it's when. So I don't have a clicker, so I'll be going back and forth here. So that's Joplin. You don't see any, not the Knoxville Fire Department, you don't see any fire police there because they're doing other things. They're asked to do a number of different things, and a lot of times 70% of our recovery is done by CDOs, NGOs, and volunteer organizations. They're asked, and people do step up and they do a wonderful job. There was a disaster they were recording this lady, and she said, you know, I'm gonna become a volunteer because the people that showed up to help us, they came with their compassion, they came with their hearts, and they didn't tell us what they were gonna do, they asked us what we needed them to do for us. So it's a good deal when people help people.
Get on board. All you need is faith to hear the dealers honing. Don't need no ticket, you just thank the Lord. So people get ready for the train to join.
Our next speaker, so I don't say it wrong, is going to be Betsy Shan. I can't believe I forgot your name, Betsy. Come on up, Betsy. Betsy and Janice have written two fantastic books. For under $30, you can be very prepared. Natural Disasters, How to Prepare For, and Natural Disasters and Man-Made Disasters. She is our keynote speaker, and glad to have her here.
What? Oh, good. But what was Stevie, the comedy part? I see Stevie a lot, so I'm going to be really quick, because I really would like you to get back and look and see what's here. So I've got a little PowerPoint. Bill's good.
Back.
Actually, what happened was back in 1993, how many people were here in 1993? Spring break quake. Remember that? I own a business downtown with a couple of girlfriends, and we had a really nice clientele. Well, the ground shook. It was 50 miles from here. It was a 5.6 earthquake, and it really shook people up. So we had a lot of people say, what am I going to do? What should I do? How should I get ready? So we put together this little booklet, and this little booklet had little checklists in it, and we went to Kinko's and some little drawings and things, and it looked cute. We gave it to our clientele, and they, being sophisticated, said, hey, that is a really good book. You know, you really have something here. Why don't you work on it? So Janice didn't come back to work for a year. She said, I'm going to go work on this. So she did a lot of research at a time when we really didn't have the internet. So she was phone calling around to fire departments, and she ended up doing a lot of research with the city of New York, Florida, Texas, California. And what happened after a year, and a lot of people bugging her to come back to work, she said, hey, guess what, I think I've written a book. So I was also working at Tektronix at the time, so went in there at night and put it on their mainframe system. Tektronix actually supported us in this endeavor by letting us put this book together and organize it on their system. We actually ended up, Mike Powell picked it up and said, you know what, I'll sell it in my store. And the next thing we knew, we were at a bookseller's convention drinking at the bar with the guy from Barnes & Noble. And by the end of the night, he said, I'm going to buy your book. And he said, great. So we had our book in every Barnes & Noble in the country. It sold out in 3 weeks nationally. That is really unheard of in the book industry. But that just shows you there was a pressing need then, and there's one now. So this was the first comprehensive book. It's still available now. It's out of print. We have a couple copies here. But really, our goal now is to move to the next phase, which includes social media. But everything that Stevie talked about earlier is in this book. It's the checklist, it's the important documents, it's knowing what you need to put together. It even tells you some lists, like when you go to the hardware store, what you should be looking for. That's why these people that have taken the time today to come here, REI, Ace Hardware, Unit Red Cross, our insurance guy, it's really important, you know, to do business with people locally. Let's talk about, well, you already know you need to prepare, but here's a really interesting fact. Everybody in this room is going to experience some kind of trauma and maybe even a natural or man-made disaster. So it's coming. You know what? It could really ruin your day. So you want to be ready. We'll snap through these, but I think it goes without saying that we want to know when we get there and we're in that situation, you know, can we help other people and who's going to help us? So if you're out there and it occurs and your family is separated, the first people that are going to help you are the people sitting next to you. So turn and look at the person next to you. You know what? How capable are you of helping in a disaster? So it is important that not only you get educated, but the person sitting next to you. So it is a culture of preparedness, and we really need it. You know what? We just saw what happened in Japan. That was probably one of the most advanced communities in the world for preparedness. We saw what happened in Christchurch, New Zealand. That community, 80% of the people there are prepared. So where do you think we fall in that category? So I think what we need to know, you know, is how to get ready and know that it's going to be really down to us. We're going to have to rely on each other. And for how long? I think Stevie alluded to that too. It's not a three-day kit anymore. You know, it's 7 to 14 to 21 days. And what he didn't say, and Dr. Gerst is sitting in the back of the room here, who's also with Multnomah County Emergency Management, we had a lunch the other day and he said, you know what? It's going to change the economics of this area for the rest of my life if we have the kind of quake that's expected. So what about that? Get ready, get the person next to you ready. Because that's the quote. And it's not mine, but you know what? It's too late. Once it starts happening, it's too late.
And war, and all of us got trampled on the floor. I wish we'd all been ready. The children died, the days grew cold. A piece of bread could buy a bag of gold. And I wish we'd all been ready. And there's no time. Change your mind, the sun has come and you've been left behind. A man and wife asleep in bed, she hears a noise and turns her head, he's gone. I wish we'd all been ready. Two men walking up a hill, one disappears and one's left standing still. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind, the sun has come and you've been left behind. Oh yeah. Spoke, the demons dying.
How could you have been so blind?